Everyone make some noise! Woo! Oh, Sally. Oh, welcome to Not On Your Right. So many familiar faces and a couple of beautiful new faces too, bless you. If you've never been before, it's so simple. It's like a panel show, except you get to play along too. So I've got a bunch of special guests. Come on out, special guests. Come on. Come on out. Come on.
They're a bit shy tonight.
Guys, do you want to see the special guests tonight?
Yeah.
They're shy. Come on. Bless them. So they'll be playing against each other. They're not playing against you. But we've got a bunch of prizes to give away. So you can get as competitive as you like. You can just sit back and enjoy the show. I don't really mind. As long as you're passionate about which side of the room you're on. So this side over here is linked to Team Patience over here. This side over here is linked to Team Jeremy over here too. It's much better. They're playing against each other, like I said. They're not playing against you. But whichever side wins, their side of the room will get 3 extra points on their score. So yeah, it's pretty good. You want to be showing them love. You want to be showing them support. You want to be the wind beneath their wings. We'll go back and meet them in a second. I'll just ask for your polite attention while we rip through introductions and then get into the silly bit. I've got some sad news too. We had a guest, Maddie Smith, on tonight who she just messaged me and said she can't make it, unfortunately. Her flight was delayed by a couple of hours, so she couldn't get here. But luckily, we've got a little beautiful mulleted boy. So you might recognize him. Stunning. It's sad because half the show was based around her stories. But luckily for us, the other half of the show is amazing. So it'll be fine. Firstly, I would like you to give it up for our band leader, Simi Lacroix. Give it up for him, everyone. Not on your rider. Stunning. Thank you, Simi. All right, let's meet our buddy panel tonight. She is the lead singer of the extremely influential Australian band, The Greats. She's toured the world, played every massive venue across this country. We love her. It's Patience Hodgson.
Thank you so much.
What's new with you, Patience?
Okay, guys. I'm just very excited because it's about to be my birthday and I am on the cusp. Just at like an incoming couple of days, I'll be turning 40. Big, filthy 40. And yeah, so I'm very, so that's really exciting. And I was actually just talking to Ben about it before we got on stage. I have these very big grand ideas about what I want to do for my birthday, which means that they're too big and then I do nothing. But then my two oldest best friends in the world have just told me that they've got me the greatest birthday present. I'm going to tell you guys what it is. Do not be upset that your friends did not give this to you for your 40th birthday. But they just, fuck man, they just bought the three of us tickets to LA. I know. Flights to LA and 4 nights in Los Angeles. So I'm going to be doing that early June. And it's the coolest, most ginormous birthday gift ever. And then to make it even more sweeter, they were like, we messaged Ben Lee and we asked him if he'd throw a party for you. So then he's going to have a little birthday party for me at his house on this Saturday.
Oh, birthday
friend
party.
Of the show.
Little name drop there. Give it up for Patience, everyone.
I'll try to get heaps of like free Not On Your Rider cameos.
Oh, yeah, thank
when
you.
When I'm in there, I'll be like, yeah, anyone who's around, I'll be, yeah.
I've blown my cameo budget, so that's great. Our first guest tonight is an incredibly funny comedian. She's a television writer and artist. She has her show at the Brisbane Comedy Festival next week. It's Emma Holland. Make her feel very welcome, please.
Oh, thanks so much for having me. I don't have friends who love me as much as that, so I've got nothing to say.
You were recently nominated for Most Outstanding Show at the Melbourne Comedy Festival for your show, yeah. Save the Orangutans. There's the poster. Incredible.
Yeah, it doesn't mean a lot in Brisbane or in the music community, but I swear it's a big deal. It's actually great.
What's the idea behind the show? There's an orangutan in your back. You've got guns.
Yeah, it's all about protection. It's basically about, I spent my whole childhood in Indonesia, and it's basically about growing up there and kind of what it was like to come back to Australia, having not lived here throughout all my formative years.
So how are you going to go to, what kind of music did you listen to in Indonesia?
Okay, so I only had 3 CDs because we had to buy them from a guy who would like illegally like scratch them onto a disc and then sell them on the side of the road. And so I had Good Charlotte, Rihanna, and Linkin Park. And I think those as like foundations has really built the person I am today.
Yeah,
yeah, the Holy Trinity, if you will.
And it's a bit of a multimedia show. Here's a clip, a picture from the show. We've got Donkey turning into some sort of jacked stallion man.
Yeah, I have a written warning from Marrickville Library for Googling that photo on their Wi-Fi. It's amazing what you can achieve when you set your mind to it.
Please give it up for Emma Holland, everyone. And down the end, last minute, literally in the last 2 hours, filling in for Maddie Smith, it's comedian Aaron Gocs.
Hi. If there's one thing you can say about me is I'm available.
What have you been up to, Goxie? You were down in Melbourne, I saw, too.
Yeah, I was in Melbourne. I was on the Comedy Fest, too. What would you call it?
Good. Official?
Yeah. I was going to say good. Not as good as the show with the Emmys, but I'm not a good salesperson, right? Yeah.
What was the name of the show?
It was called Fat and Skinny. I played the role of Fat, and my friend Jonathan played Skinny. Yeah, it was like a tribute to the classic duo, like Lane on Woodley, that sort of thing, yeah. Like, I actually damaged my voice from doing so many, like, Skinny! Yeah. So I've got it back now, thankfully. Oh, yeah.
Fantastic. And you were telling me you're going to, I don't know if we can talk about this, you're going to be on...
Yeah, we can.
Yeah? I was just going to let you say it.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
So I don't get trouble.
In the morning, I'm going to be on Triple J Like a Virgin. Yeah. Yeah. It's not me. I'm a guest with a band. But yeah, I'll take it. No. Yeah, so tune in for that. It's going
to
be fun.
All right, so you'll fly down to Sydney early morning.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, yeah.
Just live.
That's the bit I forgot about. Like,
yeah, we're not allowed to pretend. Anyway. Yeah.
Can I say that's how we first connected, was Triple J Like a Virgin?
Yes.
Because Greats did a cover of Jebediah, and I made the smallest vocal mistake in the second verse. And I remember you very kindly were like, also notice that little glitch. Like, you were just like, that's the word. Like, I can't remember, you were like, it's actually please. The word is please in the second verse. And I was like, damn, this guy knows.
Oh.
And then I was like, looking around, I was like, shit, this is guy's funny. This is comedian Aaron Gocs.
Yeah.
And I was like, thank you very much for noticing and knowing Jebediah that well.
Very slightly cyberbullying.
And I think, are you still the only person who's played that? Was it a bag?
Yeah, it was my handbag. Because I don't know how to play any instruments.
No, that was cool.
Give it up for Goxie, everyone. Yeah. Oh, he's a good boy. Over here, we've got our other team captain. It's Brisbane garage rock pioneer, Jeremy Neale.
Hey, buddies. Hey, Aimon.
I saw that you started playing shows again.
Yeah, I'm back in a big way. This time, definitely for real, at venues with microphones like this one. Yeah, it's the real deal. Same kind of vibe as usual. Like, obviously, it's been a bit of time, but same rule applies as always. No refunds.
You took a bit of time off to follow your passions of raising babies and captaining trivia night teams.
Yeah, this takes up a lot of my time, so there's not much time left for music, which is fine. But I have been pretty busy also, like patients, planning my 40th birthday, which is only 3 years away now. So I'm working on some things. I emailed Ben Lee and he hasn't replied yet. I emailed you and you haven't replied yet, which is really tricky because, like, I booked laser tag under Ben Lee and Aimon Clark, and if neither of you show up, I lose the booking. And then me and my other celebrity friends don't get to play laser tag for my 40th birthday in 3 years' time.
You might need to aim a little bit lower than Ben Lee. Maybe see if, like, Alex Lloyd's around or something.
All right, CC me on your reply,
shit,
please.
You guys are getting old as fuck. Oh, my God. I might need some younger, sexier team captains. No, not you. Oh, these
okay, cool.
You're great. Give it up for Jeremy, everyone. Next up, we've got the creator and performer of the most successful Australian magic show in history. He has had residencies at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas, West End in London, and Broadway. He was also on Big Brother, weirdly, but please make him feel very welcome. It's Christopher Wayne!
I feel like you ruined all of my amazing accolades by sprinkling Big Brother on at the end. But that's
okay.
You
did that yourself.
Yeah, that's fair. That's on me.
So you've been performing in your act, The Naked Magicians, for quite a while now. What question do you get asked the most about it?
Oh, okay. We get asked...
You say how big? Sorry.
Oh, it's fucking tiny. I'm like 6'1", and it is... small. We do meet and greets after the show. There's like about 50 to 100 people will stay back and do a Q&A. And there's three questions that we always get asked. Number one is, have our parents ever seen the show? What do you think? Yes or no?
Yeah. I'd say yes, yeah. I suppose.
Someone over there said yes just so fast, like they've met my mum. That was amazing. Yes, they have many times. My mum's seen it 25 times now. Second question, do we actually get our penises out, our magic wands?
Yeah, well, I would never ask such a basic question, but out of interest, what is the answer?
what would your bet be there? And wow, okay, there's my actual mum. yeah, it's true, yes, we do get our wangs out. And the third one is, have we ever had an erection on stage?
Oh my God.
And that was my dad. No. No, we got through 1,400 shows erection-free. But which I'm really proud of.
It's better than me. No.
Let's not applaud. Let's not applaud that. That's all for you, buddy. That's all for you.
Please give it up for Christopher Wayne, everyone. Lastly, it's a Brisbane legend from Regurgitator. It's Ben Eli. You recently performed a massive show celebrating 25 years of Unit. Congratulations.
Well, thank you.
How was that show?
It was really great. It kind of reminded me of like a 4ZZZ car park market day kind of thing, because we played with all these Brisbane punk bands and stuff. It was really nice. You know, it's nice after the pandemic and everything. Yeah.
So it still sounds... I feel like the album when it came out was like 10 years before its time, and it still sounds pretty current now. It's pretty rare that a band has been playing those songs for 25 years and still playing such huge venues. What do you attribute that to?
I think we just are in denial about getting older. We still act like we are 3 years old, so just keep that up, I think.
Maybe. Well, you might just be really good as well, too, of course.
It just kind of looks funny when you're old and you act like a juvenile, though. But, you know, we'll get there.
Am I allowed to ask Ben a question?
Yes, please.
Okay, this might be a bit creepy. we might have a connection. So my mum bought a house in Brisbane 5 years ago, and one of the selling points from the real estate agent was that one of the members of Regurgitator's mums used to own it, and it's where you recorded one of your albums, in the downstairs room.
Yeah, we used to rehearse in Baden, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, my God, yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Anyway, she bought it, and I lived in there during the pandemic.
Yeah, we used to always rehearse there. The only reason the band started was I wanted to get some weed, and I heard that Kwan's mum had a really good stash.
Don't worry.
He doesn't drink or smoke or anything, and but yeah, that's how the band started, basically. Yeah.
We named our drink menu after you guys tonight too. It's the I Sucked a Lot of Cocktails list. We've got the Tanqueray Loose Unit, the Jameson Everyday Formula, and the $6 tins of I Will Lick Your Green Beacon was the closest I could do for that one. But give it up for Ben Eli, everyone. We're so stoked to have him. Same prizes as usual. First place gets 5 double passes to the Triffid. Hot stuff. Second place gets a $100 voucher. Third place gets a $50 voucher. Oh, also first place will get the limited edition Unit vinyl, which I might try and get Ben to sign tonight. Yeah, all right. We've got a bunch of Green Beacon beers, a bottle of Tanqueray, a bottle of Jameson Black Barrel, and some Burger Urge burgers to give away. It's the same rules as always. Obviously, no phones, no cheating. Spelling doesn't matter. As long as most letters are there in some sort of reasonable order, you get the point. No yelling out, of course. And please circle Jeremy or Patience on your answer sheet right now to show which side you're on. Patience, Jeremy. And put your team name on every answer sheet, too. You'd be surprised at how hard that is. Some of the team names that I liked for tonight that I saw come through were the Flaming Lip Fillers. Where are you guys? Woo! Great team name. We've got Jen Cloaca too. So like a Jen Cloa. Yeah, very good. We've got Quizzo. It's like Lizzo, but Quizzo, yeah? Limp Quizkit. I like that. Quizness Secrets of the Pharaohs. Peep Show reference. Love it. Greta Van Fleet's cover band. us last time. Love it. Good on you. Of course, Daddy Bonglegs is back, of course. Yeah, all right. And this was a cool team name. Make the Noises from Corn Twist. Where are you guys? It's from memory. It's like... Yeah, that's pretty good. Let's get into it. Round one. Here we bloody go. Question one. On which date did Earth, Wind & Fire talk about love changing the minds of pretenders? On which date? Now, if that means nothing to you, I'll say, do you remember when Earth, Wind & Fire talked about love changing the minds of pretenders? When was that? Question two, also known as the Men in Black, who released the 1968 album At Folsom Prison? Also known as the Men in Black, who released the 1968 album At Folsom Prison? Question three is an audio question. So I need you to identify the songs from the 8-bit versions. There's gonna be four of them for 4 points. Just the song titles, please. I'll play them twice. Here we go. Question five, moving forward. This is two answers for 2 points if you can do it. Which two of the most loved and longest running musicals of all time are loosely based on Shakespeare plays? They're two big musicals, most loved and longest running musicals of all time. They're loosely based on Shakespeare plays. 2 points. Question six. This is going to be two answers for 2 points. This is a really good question. I see how you feel about it. In the early 2000s, which two massive, massive hit songs mentioned Lucy Liu in their titles? Sorry, not in their titles, in their lyrics, I should say. In the early 2000s, which two massive hit songs mentioned Lucy Liu in their lyrics? Should be. Question seven. This song's from the 80s, I believe. I forgot to write it down. Which Thai city is referenced in a number one hit song by Murray Head that was written by Benny and Björn from ABBA? What was that Thai city that's referenced in a number one hit song by Murray Head? Came out in the 80s. Question eight. You all know this one, Chris. From the theme song of the hit series Mind Freak, Chris Angel collaborated with the lead singer of which band? And it's multiple choices. Limp Bizkit? Was it the lead singer of Korn, The Offspring, or Led Zeppelin? Here is that intro if you want a little taste of it. It's pretty cool. Anyway, that was more for me than you. Who did he collaborate with?
He is the most painful fucking magician on the planet. He's a nightmare.
Oh, tell me all about that during the answers, please. I might come into the audience to give away some beers. Does that sound good? Yeah. All right, we're going to play a little game. The Triffid's going to choose four tables for me, and we're going to play a game called Lama Del Rey. I'm going to give you a quote. Is this from the Dalai Lama or Lana Del Rey? Okay. It's harder than it sounds. Triffid, choose me a table. Who is it? Over there. Here's weird walking music. Okay, your quote. Here it comes. When I walk outside, people have something to say about it. It's Lana Del Rey. Well done. I will get you a little prize too, because it does kind of look like it's on your table as well. All right, choose another one for me, please. Oh. Please don't be the empty table. This always happens. Oh, my God. All right, let's go over there. Your quote is, "My religion is very simple. My religion is kindness." Dalai Lama? That's correct. Well done. You got some beers. Take that to the bar. Oh, sorry. I dropped it. Choose me another one, please. Oh, my gosh. It was so close to this one again. Okay. To you, ladies. Okay. Ask her. All right. Your quote is, "Know the rules well so you can break them." What do you think? I'll just chuck an answer out. I'll give you a prize anyway. Lana Del Rey. Oh, it's the Dalai Lama, but you can bloody have it. Go on, you're all right. And one more, please. Here we go. Who wants it? Oh, down there. Okay, all right. Cool. That's convenient for me. Okay. Yours is... "Suck my tongue." It's the Dalai Lama. Well done. Give him a clap. Thank you. Oh, cool.
Suck my tongue. Before
you go. Thank you. All right, question 9 for 4 points. This will take a little bit of explaining. So I'm going to give you some drag queens that have names that are based on celebrities. I want you to tell me the drag queen's name. So there's a drag queen in Brisbane called Penelope Cruises. Her name is based on Penelope Cruz, of course. This drag queen has a name that's based on Pauline Hanson. What do you think their name could be? I don't expect you to know these, but you could have a good guess, and it's a little bit of fun to figure out. B is based on Cheryl Cole. What do you think her name might be? Based on Cheryl Cole. See, this one is has a name based on Avril Lavigne. What do you think a drag queen with a name based on Avril Lavigne might be called? And lastly, this one's based on Amy Winehouse. Amy Winehouse, my favorite one too. And keep thinking about that, but we're gonna move on to the final question of this round. This is gonna be another 4-pointer. 4 answers for 4 points. Which 4 instruments beginning with T might you find in a standard orchestra? 4 instruments beginning with T for tango. All right, that is the end of that round. So please swap your answer sheets over with a team nearby. It doesn't matter how many times you swap,
swapping your
as
sheets.
Long as you don't have your own answer sheet in front of you. Answers, please swap if you haven't done so already. You should have. Go on, swap them over. All right. Question 1, on which date did they talk about love changing the minds of pretenders? Patience, when was it?
Okay. We think it could be this. Do you remember? The 21st night of September.
September's September. Correct.
September. I almost said December.
Oh my gosh. September 21st. At Folsom Prison, Ben, what did you guys have for that?
Johnny Cash.
Johnny Cash is correct. Now, I bring this up because you performed in a prison once.
Yes, I did when I was very young. And when I was young, I looked younger than I should have. And it was terrifying.
That seems very irresponsible. How did that happen?
I will, you know, I'll bring up 4ZZZ again. But 4ZZZ used to, in the 90s, used to do a thing where local bands could go and play in Wake Hall Maximum Security Prison. You know, and perform for the, you know, the cons. Yeah, it was probably the most terrifying concert I've ever played.
And how did you feel just getting there?
Well, I got there and, you know, you had to you get searched when you go in, and they gave you this little tattoo so they know that you're a visitor. And luckily, I got there a little bit earlier because I searched my base case and found a little roach in my base case. So luckily, I didn't take it in with me.
And did you end up jamming with a prisoner too? Did I know?
Yeah, we did. Like, there was this really lovely Indigenous fella who hadn't played or jammed in a band for 15 years because I think 15 years ago, someone broke all of the band gear. And when we played with him, I've never seen someone so full of joy playing lead guitar blues lead guitar before.
What was he in for?
Oh, I didn't ask him. Okay. I did talk to one guy who was in there for, murder. I mean, they were all murderers, basically. It was very difficult.
Was he good at guitar?
He was really good at guitar.
Oh, okay, oh, thank God.
Yeah, he was great. It was really good. Yeah.
You didn't have to tell him he was bad, obviously. Yeah.
And they taught me how to make a tattoo gun as well.
Oh.
Yeah.
There's a bit of a cultural exchange going on.
That's right, cultural exchange.
Beautiful. For question three, identify the songs from the 8-bit versions. We had Sledgehammer, we had Monkey Wrench, Wrecking Ball, and Boyfriend by Justin Bieber as well. They're all songs about tools. That's me being a bit edgy. Calling Justin Bieber a tool. I try not to get too political on this show. Okay, the two sets of artists with songs called Over and Over. Aaron, what did you have for that?
Oh, Hot Chip.
Yeah.
That was, these guys were, and then I provided this answer. Tim McGraw featuring Nelly.
Yeah, it was Nelly featuring Tim McGraw, that's correct. Yeah.
Oh, well, controversial, sorry.
Nelly?
Maybe it was a 50-50 collab.
Yeah. So, back in America, Maddie's on a show called Wild and Out, and she just had an episode with Nelly air. What do you think it was like for her meeting Nelly?
Just love the panic and you try to like force a question that you'd clearly written for someone else.
Yeah.
How was her experience?
Yeah, what do you think it was like twerking on Nelly? Do you think it was pretty cool?
I do.
Yeah, cool, thank you. Awesome. Christopher, question five. The two musicals, what did you have for that?
Okay, there's one of them that I'm so sure on and that's The Lion King.
Yes!
That's correct.
Okay, the second one was a bit of a stab in the dark. Went with Phantom of the Opera.
It's West Side Story, Romeo and Juliet. Phantom of the Opera is based on a book by a French guy called Gaston Leroux, I think. But I talked about it earlier. You've done residencies in London's West End, in Broadway, but probably the most impressive for magic is Las Vegas, right?
Yes, sir. That was good. We were we had a year-long residency at MGM Grand, which was cool.
That sounds incredible. Did you get to meet any of the... like the magicians there?
Oh, yeah. Okay, so at MGM, it was us, Lady Gaga, and David Copperfield every night. Lady Gaga wasn't having it, but we got to spend a lot of time with David. He actually was the one that allowed us, like MGM, to bring another magic show into the casino because he had, it was like his territory. So he welcomed us, and we spent a lot of time with him, which was cool. I have a David Copperfield tattoo on my body because I've loved magic since I was like a kid. And then he came to the Naked Magicians, and then after the show, he's like, hey, is that a tattoo of me on your body? And so
he saw the tattoo.
Where's the tattoo?
That it doesn't matter where it is or what it is or any of that stuff. No, I don't. That's the wrong show. You chant that. So he was cool, and Penn and Teller were great, and then we showed him around Brisbane when they came to Australia, which was really cool. All the magicians were so welcoming, lovely, and imposter syndrome times 100 for us, for sure.
I was going to say, if you weren't already called the Naked Magicians, you could have called yourself David Copperfield, maybe?
Or Show and Teller.
Show and Teller, hey, oh my God. Right. David Copperfield and Show... Well, I know this is your night off, but is there a chance you could show us some sort of trick tonight? Illusion, sorry.
Yeah, I bought playing cards. I can do a trick on the stage after. I might need like a mic stand. If there's one, can I keep my clothes on tonight?
No.
Ah.
Sorry.
Oh my God, you sound like my uncle. I'll do a trick after for sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can you do it right now? Is that right?
Oh, you want to do it right now?
Yeah, is that okay?
If we can get a microphone stand right there, is it okay if I do a trick? Is that okay?
Good. Saw me in half. Let's do it. This is actually really.
this is scary. In the Naked Magicians, we kind of like, if the stuff doesn't work out, like a joke doesn't land or a trick doesn't work, we just get our dicks out and then it's fine. But this kind of...
Me too.
What's your name, sir? Lee, name any... one card in my pocket, name any card in the world. Ace of... Oh, your eyes lit up, though. That was cool. Can I do a trick on you? Is that okay?
Oh, please.
Would you come and stand next to me? I guess, can we give him a round of applause? I guess we'd say that. Because it's a magic show now.
I'm shy.
Hey, we'll do a card trick.
Okay.
So I did bring a deck of cards. And the only thing that makes this trick more fun for me is if someone films it really close on their smartphone. Like, really close. Perfect. Okay, great. That's cool. So this is a... like a deck of cards, of course. So we know it's a real deck, regular deck. Can you give that a quick shuffle? Now that we've done that, the next note, you can mix it up. Like, it doesn't really matter because the trick's gonna... Everyone knows the card trick, right? This isn't a trick from the Naked Magicians or anything. I'm just gonna come up with something stupid right now. So we're gonna do something that'll start like a normal card trick and then get very different very quickly. Take a card out, just one, and this is the normal part. Then it'll start to get different. So, Aimon, I want you to take that card and take this. That's my weed pen. Shit. That's not even a joke. That's literally drugs. Can you write your name?
Is there any police here? Please.
Write your name in big letters on that side of your card. And while he's doing that, I'll teach you guys a quick trick. You can make it look like a card appears and disappears like this. I know. Anyone can do that, and all you do is you're just pinching a card. When you throw, you move your hand into the air, you pinch the card behind your top two and bottom two fingers. Anyone can do it. It doesn't matter if your hand's big and small. And from front on, it looks like my hand's empty, but then in slow motion, I do this. I go, what? Now, at full speed, you can show both sides of your hand, the back, then the front, and then do it. And then it looks like this if you do it right.
What?
I'm fucking with you. I can't do that stuff. That's why I have to, you know. So I'll take the pen. Fantastic. You signed it, right? Okay, cool. Can you show everyone the card and your name and your signature, all that fun stuff?
Yes!
Did you draw a little penis on it or not?
No.
Okay. Okay. I'll get you to stick it in about halfway down, right about there. Rest of the deck goes on top. Can you come stand right next to me? Now, for this next part, magicians are known at being good with their hands. That's called sleight of hand. We're not going to use sleight of hand to find your card. We're going to use sleight of mouth, okay? So, here we go.
Well, I couldn't do this trick in COVID, but now I can, because we're going to sing together, and we think of a card, I'll fly, and we'll go, whoa! Okay, here we go. Is that your card? No. It's not? No. Is it that? Wait, that one? No. Fuck, one card. Oh. One card, in my mouth, your son card.
Thank you. Yes?
No. Fuck. Oh my God. What was your...
It was the Jack of Clubs, I think. I wrote my name on it, anyway. No, you didn't need it.
One card that has been folded in to quarters. Why aren't you stopping me as I go lower? But Aimon, if we've done it right, it should be, you said the Jack of Clubs and you signed it right there. Is that you?
That's it, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, and my amazing volunteer, Aimon.
Thank you.
Oh, you can keep it, it's chill.
Thank you.
Wow. Okay, then the rest of the night's gonna be shit compared to that, sorry.
Back to the stupid trivia, I suppose. The two songs. That was really cool, thank you. The two songs were... Here we go. Like a pro, now I'll be young, and lose the news.
It was Hey Ya. And did you have the other one, Emma?
We know it's by Destiny's Child. We can't remember the name
of it. Can I just say we said women independent women?
Independent women, part one. Yes. Well done. Independent women, Hey Ya. They both kind of reference Beyonce too, which is interesting. There you go. Ben, the Thai city. I think I saw you, a little light bulb go off above your head for question 7, that Thai city.
Yep.
What'd you have?
Well, I think the song is One Night in Bangkok, is it?
That's correct. Yes. Bangkok is correct.
Because my mum had that on record.
Really?
My mum, she liked Enya too.
You recorded your debut album in Bangkok too.
We did, yeah.
Why would you do such a thing?
Our drummer used to go there all the time. He was kind of dodgy. Yeah. Yeah, but we found a really cheap studio because we're that kind of band. And it was really cool, but we stayed in this abandoned hotel. We had to walk through this swamp that had alligators and packs of wild dogs. So when we came home at the end of the day, we had to carry big sticks with us to fight the dogs.
Really?
Yeah. It was an exciting time to be alive.
Sounds like, did you see anything else weird while you were there? Like,
yeah, Quan and I were walking home one night, and we saw, you know, a street light, and we saw this, you know, it looked like a giant bird was flying around the light at night. We're like, why is this bird doing out in the middle of the night? And then it swooped down at Quan's face and nearly bit his face off, and it was a giant moth. Oh. It was about that big.
Oh, my.
Asia, man's wild.
Yeah. A behemoth, you might say.
Behemoth, yes. That's
pretty
true.
Great. Thank you.
It was.
Security.
Okay. Chris Angel. Well, here's the video of the like back behind the scenes. I am mind-free. Oh, it's badass. It's Jonathan Davis from Korn. Well done if you got that. Korn. You said that Chris Angel. No, you don't want to talk about Chris Angel? I've got a bit of a Chris Angel story, actually, if you want to hear it.
Yeah, I'd love to hear it.
It's actually not my story. So a guy told it to me. Anyway, he works down on the Gold Coast. He works in music. And I hope he doesn't mind me bringing this up. If he does, I'll cut it out of the recording. What a freaking mind freak story, am I right? Is that the story you were going to say? Should I not have told that?
You tell whatever story you want, but since we're there and I've had half a beer... A friend of mine hooked up with him, and he on the way out, he's like, "Wait, I want to give you something," and then she's like, "Oh," and then he gave her a protein bar. Yeah, like he's like, "Yeah, it's for you."
Oh, he's a nice guy. All right.
Yeah, it's great.
Is this where I make my confession?
No. What's your confession? Oh, if you want.
I feel like this is where I need to make my confession. That back during my just after I'd separated horny phase.
Are you ready? I am mine. Sorry.
No, I fucking would have. I would have. Like, I would have. But I was trying to get on to Chris. Back in my very
This would be
horny
fun
phase.
To talk about off stage, I reckon. This is, you know what I think? That'd be fun.
We was having some chats on the DMs. Didn't really go anywhere. But there was like a thing for a little while there that we had going on.
I was down. It was just during the pandemic.
And during the pandemic.
All you could do
this
was...
This is recent. Well, 2020.
Yeah. It was still...
Like 2020. I think, but do you remember...
This was pre-QR codes.
Did
you know,
anybody
so
remember I actually said it on stage?
Fuck, man.
I was so excited about potentially going on a date with you. One time during my introduction, I even said so patient.
Oh, I thought you were talking about Chris Angel.
Here's Christopher. That he was like, what have you got going on? And I was like, was anyone here when I said that? Oh, I think I'm going on a date with the Naked Magician next week. And then everyone was like, how did your date go? And I was like, oh, it didn't happen. Like, we didn't meet up. Sorry.
Not on your rider.
We gonna...
Synergy.
Yeah, I mean, we're here now. Yeah. And all of a sudden, my surprise invitation to be on a music trivia show with no music history in my life makes a lot more sense. a lot more sense. They're like, hey, we got this show that's all about music. Want to come on, do a card trick? And I'm like, yeah, that makes no sense. I'm in. And then now we get on stage and say, hey, Chris, I planned a flash mob. Let's go.
While we're on magic, I once got asked out by a magic trick.
How'd that happen?
Well, this, I don't know. I'd like to know Chris's opinion on whether this is a good one or not. But
no,
the guy...
never ask a girl out with a fucking magic trick.
I thought it was shit out.
Please tell me.
The guy walked up to me. I was working at a flower market. And I'd been there the week before, and he'd seen me the week before and decided he was going to ask me out. So he came prepared, which I hated. And he walked up to me, and he was wearing like a white shirt and a jacket. And he goes, what do you think of men who wear pink? And I was like, it's fine. I don't give a shit. And he's like, do you find it attractive? And I was like, I don't know. Mind you, I was 18. I was like very fresh into the dating scene. And he goes, if I was wearing pink right now, would you give me your number? And I went, and I didn't even answer. And he turned around and he just did like this motion and then turned back and he was wearing a pink shirt instead of his white one. And then I was so uncomfortable, I gave him my number and then we went on a date and it was the worst date of my life.
That's where I know you from. Oh my God.
Oh!
Emma, while I've got you, what did you have for the drag queen names? The one based on Pauline Hanson.
We had Pauline Pants Down.
Pauline Pants Down is correct. Where is it? Oh, there it is. Pauline Pants Down, based on Cheryl Cole.
We just wrote Cheryl Hole.
Cheryl Hole is correct. Well done. Avril Lavigne.
Avril Latrine.
Avril Latrine is correct. Well done. Avril Latrine. And Amy Winehouse.
We were really lost with this one. We just wrote Amy Winehouse, but we made it three names instead of two.
Okay, that's... What did you guys have?
This is... I know that this performer exists. I just don't know if she's a drag performer or not. Amy House Wine.
Amy House Wine is correct. Well done. Amy House Wine, the best one of them all. You did drag recently. What was your drag name?
My drag name was True Detective.
It's pretty good.
It's pretty good. Yeah.
And the four instruments I was looking for... A trumpet is one. A tuba is another. A trombone. Yep. Timpani. And if you're a bit lowbrow, maybe triangle. I'll give it to you. Bloody go on. All right, mark that answer sheet. Put the total at the top. Give it back to the team it belongs to. Double check. Make sure it's marked correctly and added up correctly. Karen's going to come along and collect just round one. So please rip that off for her. We're going to have a 5-minute break. So head to the bar, grab some Jameson or gin cocktails, Tanqueray cocktails, $6 bloody cans of green bacon. Get it in, y'all. We'll see you in 5 minutes. Four. But in a couple of weeks, at the Fortitude Music Hall, they're doing the Lord of the Rings and Hobbit concert. And it's sold out. There's an orchestra doing all the music from Lord of the Rings and the Hobbit. Do you want to give away a double pass to that? Do you people want to do that? All right. We're going to play a little game called Legolas or Legoland. I'm going to give you a name of something. I need you to tell me, is it a chapter from Lord of the Rings or is it a ride at Legoland? So we're going to get everyone to stand up. Stand up. Last person standing wins. Sorry, you got to stand up. So let's try it. Let's say, for example, the answer is Legoland. Everybody point to that side of the screen using this arm. Everyone, Legoland. Let's try it. Legoland. Oh, stunning. Okay. If the answer is a chapter from Lord of the Rings, we point to that side of the screen there with this other arm. Yes, everyone's... Oh, look at you. You're doing real well. Okay. Here we go. You guys can play too if you want. It's up to you. Dune Raiders. Ride at Legoland or chapter from Lord of the Rings. Dune Raiders. Okay, the answer is Legoland ride. I'm sorry. Next up, Flight to the Ford. Lock in your answers. The answer is... Lord of the Rings, all right, well done. The White Rider. Oh, Lord of the Rings, correct. Coast Cruise. That was great, Legoland, all right, well done. Dragon Hunt. Which one? Legoland, okay. Royal Joust. Legoland is correct. The Forbidden Pool. It's Lord of the Rings. All right, all done. And the dragon. It's Legoland. And this is the point where I ran out of options. So we're doing, is this a rock song about Lord of the Rings or a chapter from Lord of the Rings? Okay, rock song or chapter? Three is Company. Rock song? Rock song. Lord of the Rings. It's Lord of the Rings. Okay. Frodo, don't wear the ring. It's a song. It's Fly the Conchords, all right? Rivendell. No, it's a song by Bloody Rush. Yeah. Who's still playing? Put your hand up. You? You're still playing.
We've got one on the mezzanine, I think.
One on the mezzanine?
Yep.
Where are you? Sorry, person who had put their hand up, are you still playing or are you just being a cheeky bugger? Put your hand up if you're playing, please. This isn't for points or anything. Put your hand up if you're still playing the game, please. No one. Okay. Fuck. All right. Are you actually still playing? Wait. Oh, no. Thank you.
I just got it. What's going on?
I like your attitude. Okay. Well, that means everyone who got out in that last round gets to stand back up. Okay? All right? Yeah? Stunning. Okay. Land of the Shadow or the Land of Shadow. Which one? It's Lord of the Rings. Okay. Everyone's doing well. Shadows. It's a song by Sabaton. Next up, Shadow of the Past. Oh, it's Lord of the Rings. Is it just you? Did anyone, oh, over there? Can you guys come over here so I can have a look at you? Look at you. Give them a clap, they're doing so well. We'll just do it here. We don't need to go to the front. Okay. Shadow from Mordor, another shadow one. Okay, we're both going that way. Correct. Battle of Evermore. Correct. Look, you guys are good. All right. A Journey in the Dark. Okay, you guys are correct. All right. I've run out. But we're going to play a little game, okay? I'm going to need an answer about Lord of the Rings from you, okay? So you got to buzz in. You got to say Aimon and put your hand up to buzz in. Then you got to give me the answer straight away, okay? Is that right? Okay. Sharing its name with a famous singer. What is the name of Frodo's sword? You've got to say Aimon.
Sting.
Sting is correct. Well done. Woo! Oh, you did so well, though. Come see me afterwards. I'll get you details. Give it up for this guy, too. He did very well. Thank you. Team Jeremy is on 16 points.
Oh, yay!
Reasonable. Team Patience is on 19 points.
Woo!
Anything could happen. Let's get back into it. Round two. Question 11. Give me the acronym hit song titles that these artists release. So I'm going to give you the artist. You need to give me the acronym song title. So if I said Village People, the answer would be YMCA, of course. A, Michael Jackson. B, ABBA. C, Wu-Tang Clan. And D, Cardi B. What are the acronym song titles? Also, that man who came second in the Lord of the Rings round, you've got a bottle of Tanqueray, a little cheeky Tanqueray. You did very well. Buddy, good on you. Come see me afterwards. I don't trust you to have it now. All right, question 12. Dick Dale's surf rock song, Miss Ilu, featured prominently in Tarantino's 1994 film, Pulp Fiction. Which hit song from 2006 sampled it too? Surf rock song sampled in a hit song, 2006. What is it? Now, I haven't done this before, but I thought it'd be a cute little fun way for our guests to earn extra points for their team. It could be fun. I'm going to get the Triffid to choose one person on stage to have a little power quick fire round. Okay, Triffid, please choose me. Who's going to play? Which one's it going to be? Is it going to be you? Perhaps you. Is it going to be me? I think that's on Chris. Okay. Chris, your round, your specialty round, is Quentin Tarantino films. So I'm going to give you a quick fire round. Okay. Here we go.
I'm good for this.
Can I get some, like,
I'm taking my glasses
stressful
off.
Music? Thank you. What is the name of the fictional burger restaurant referenced in several Tarantino films?
Big Kahuna Burger.
Correct. Which TV show was Rick Dalton the star of?
Oh, fuck. Can I swear on stage? And it was Bounty Law.
Correct. There's a special rung in hell for people who waste good what?
Scotch.
Jameson Irish Whiskey is the correct answer. No, Scotch is right.
Yeah. But,
what was the bride snake themed code name?
Black Mamba.
Correct. Excluding a couple of flashbacks, which two Tarantino movies take place over a 24-hour period?
As in specifically 24 hours?
Yes.
Or, the one of the Hateful Eight and Reservoir Dogs.
Correct, correct. Well done. What is Buck here to do?
Fuck!
Yuck! Which two Quentin Tarantino films feature the main character's name in the title?
Kill Bill and Django.
Kill Bill! Bill's not the bloody main character.
Jackie Brown.
It was Jackie Fuck. Brown. All right, you got 8 out of 9 for that. Well done. Give him a clap. That was pretty good. Pretty good. All right, but back to you guys. Question 13. Identify the artists from what their fans call them. So, like, Lady Gaga, their fans, the little monsters. Anyway, A is the Deadheads. Who calls themselves Deadheads? B, who calls themselves Juggalos? C, who calls them Smilers? And D, Gold Diggers. Which artist? Gold Diggers. Deadheads, Juggalos, Smilers, and Gold Diggers. Good question, Goxy. What are Not On Your Rider fans known as? Mad Dogs?
Easy Riders.
Easy Riders, all right. Flow Riders, that's way better. You're all Flow Riders, I hope. Okay, I've got an audio question for you. I need you to identify the songs from the Simi version. Simi's going to play us 4 versions of songs. We just need the song titles. He's going to play them twice too. Please, Simi, take it away when you're ready. The fuck? For Simi, everyone. Question 15. This might be a bit tricky, but I'm sure you can figure it out. Which guitarist played on Alanis Morissette's You Oughta Know, P. Diddy's Bad Boys for Life, Christina Aguilera's Fighter, Red Hot Chili Peppers' Aeroplane, and Jane's Addiction's Been Caught Stealing. All right, while you think about that, I'm going to give another person a chance to win points for their team. Let's spin those lights. Who's it going to be? Oh, here he bloody comes. I hope it's on this side. Oh, it's Emma. Oh, okay. Your round, sorry. Your round is, I need you to complete the, it's not too hard. I need you to complete the titles of these number one songs from the 1980s.
Okay.
Give me the titles from these number one songs from the 19... Oh, stressful music, thank you. I just called to say I love...
Texting.
80s, 80s.
We don't need another...
Harry Potter reboot.
This is much better. Don't worry, be...
Happy.
Yeah, okay. Girls just want to have...
25% of the income for the same job. fun.
Wake me up before you...
Go.
Yeah, all right. Hungry like the...
Hungry hippo.
That's correct,
wolf,
actually.
Wolf, no, it's wolf.
No, hippos. No, come on.
The towel, that's why I put it there.
Maroons.
Do you really want to?
Come on, Eileen.
get out of my dreams. Get into my
head.
No, car.
Car.
And addicted to.
Watching caving disasters on TikTok. That's more me personally.
Is addicted to love. I'm sorry.
I knew all of them.
Okay, well, that was really good. give it up for Emma, everyone. But just in case I put you on the spot, I had a backup way for you to earn as many points as Chris did. For a total of 8 points, do you reckon you could do 10 juggles with a soccer ball? Because I know you used to play soccer.
I know I can outdoors. I've never done it in front of people or with such a small space, but I can definitely try.
Do you want to have a go?
Yeah.
Okay,
here we go. I'm wearing bike shorts under my skirt. I'm going to take my skirt off. Hang on.
All right.
So maybe 10 was what we're looking for. Yeah, we go. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Two more goes. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, she did it! All right, I'll round you up to 8 points for that to make it equal. Good stuff. Give it up for Emma, please, this time. Oh. Question 6. Oh, back to the trivia, sorry. Question 16. Which 1991 Guns N' Roses album featured the songs Don't Cry and November Rain? 1991 Guns N' Roses album that featured Don't Cry and November Rain. Question 17. According to two top 10 hits in the 1980s by Roxette and Madness, what must it have been? According to the song titles by Roxette and Madness, what must it have been? Question 18 for 2 points. Here's a good one. Which two songs from 1990 went to number one in Australia with the word touch in their titles? Two songs from 1990 that went to number one in Australia with the word touch. All right, people seem pretty confident about that one. This next one's three answers for 3 points. It's a bit tricky. You'll know the answers, though. What are the titles of Tchaikovsky's three ballets? So they're three very famous ones. And question 20. Which Sesame Street character's voice is often referenced in death metal singing styles? Which Sesame Street character's voice is often referenced when talking about death metal singing styles? We've never done this before, too. I thought it'd be a bit fun. After the break, the next break we're going to have, I was thinking we could have a death metal growl contest. So if you're up for it. Patience and Jeremy will each go into the crowd and choose two champions from their side. They're going to compete in the death metal contest. They'll come up on stage, we'll play a little song, and you got to give your like best death metal kind of scream. Like this, for example. Oh, wait, I'll play like a little song, and then you got to like... Bleh. Okay, so let me play it. You do it your way. That's just my way of doing it. But think if you want to... All right. Here come the answers. Emma, what did you guys have? Please swap them over. Everyone swapped. I'm still so buzzing from your freaking
I can't
juggling.
Tell you the amount of adrenaline pumping through my body right now. I feel alive.
question 11. A.
A.
Michael Jackson.
PYT.
PYT is correct. ABBA.
SOS.
SOS. They're both bloody acronyms. Anyway, Wu-Tang Clan.
C-R-E-A-M.
Correct.
And that's a Gocs. That's a Gocs special.
Bloody well done. And also known as a Gocs special, what was the last one?
WAP.
WAP is correct. Well done. Question 12. We'll throw this over to Chris, our Tarantino expert. What was the name of that song?
I wrote a show about Tarantino, which is why it keeps coming up. I realised without context, I'd be like, why the fuck do they keep asking him Quentin Tarantino questions? Pump It by the Black Eyed Peas.
Pump It by the Black Eyed Peas.
Yes.
Now,
yes.
Chris, you've written a show called Two Man Tarantino.
What? Why would you bring that up?
It's at the comedy festival coming up too. How fun.
That's great. I'm not in it, but it was something that I wrote when I was touring in the Naked Magicians. It's called Two Man Tarantino, and it plays at the comedy festival for the last 2 weeks of the festival. Yeah.
What was the inspiration behind it? Why did you end up writing a Tarantino show?
This is kind of funny. Well, it's funny to me. So it's set in the last video store in Australia, and the shopkeeper and the customer have 1 hour to recreate every single Quentin Tarantino film with the last 60 minutes that this store is open. And I was stoned in, I think it was LA, and we were watching, do you guys remember the Sham Wow guy? That's where I got the idea. So I was with, I can't say who I was with, but they were stoned too. And they
sorry.
Yeah, let's go with that. I was with him, and we were talking. We were really stoned and talking about that, and talking about we were trying to do the commercial. You know, Sham Wow. You'll be saying wow every time, and then because we were high, we're like, that sounds a bit like Christopher Walken. And then so we're sitting on these hotel beds going, Sham Wow, Sham Wow. You'll be saying wow every time, man. And because we were high and we were just laughing, so we were caught in this loop, you know. The house, the boat, it'll clean it all. And we were stuck. And I'm like, how funny would that be, like two people just recreating Quentin Tarantino characters? And we did some semi-al, but I'll get cancelled if I do that bit here. And it was fun. And then I'm like, I think there's a bit in this. So it was going to be Two Men Pulp Fiction. And then I'm like, no, I think it'd be funnier if it was the challenge of every single Quentin Tarantino film in an hour. And that's how it happened. We played it during the, in 2021. It did a sold out run, and then we were gonna release another month of shows, and then there was something, because we weren't an NRL game, it got canceled, yeah.
We're gonna give away a double pass to Two Men Tarantino tonight. That's,
yeah,
that's right.
You can give away more if you want, but okay. Two's a great start.
Okay.
Yeah.
We'll give it one to the top 10, and what about something to do with a Christopher Walken impression?
If they, like, it's a fun impression,
yeah.
And if there was anyone that felt competent enough to give it a crack or a few people, I would be happy to gift like another double pass. To the secret is you say wow, and you if you start pretending you have an invisible accordion in your hands while you say wow, and then from there the rest of your body follows suit. So yeah, I'd be wow. happy with that. Yeah,
I got a watch up my ass. I can't do it.
He put the watch up his ass. Yeah.
Does anyone have a Christopher Walken impression?
It doesn't have to be good, as you might have just noticed. Yeah.
This guy has.
Fuck right. Yeah.
All right. Sorry to derail the trivia with this, but all right. Let's have a go.
This might is specifically from when he introduced the Foo Fighters on SNL, and he goes, "Ladies and gentlemen, the Foo Fighters."
I think that has to be the winner, just straight up. Well done.
Hell yeah. Let's do details after the show and you can come in.
I just want to know how long you've been waiting to, like, perform that publicly.
Because it was Christopher Walken and music themes, too. Extra points. Two-Man Tarantino is on the show. I'm supposed to put that up before. Question 13. The artist from what the fans call themselves... Jeremy, we haven't heard from you in a bit.
Yeah, hey, I'm back. It's the Grateful Dead.
Grateful Dead's correct.
Insane Clown Posse.
Yes.
This is a bit of...
I will also accept fans of Emma Holland, the true juggalette. Smilers?
Smilers, look, we don't know. We went with Miley Cyrus.
Oh, what did you guys go with?
Yep, Miley Cyrus.
That's correct. Miley Cyrus.
Gould Diggers, we were Ellie Goulding.
Ellie Goulding is correct. Well done.
I thought it was Phil Gould.
Give me the songs from the Simi versions. We had You're Beautiful, then it was Music, then Chad Kroger's hit song Hero in the Spider-Man soundtrack, and Without Me was the last one. It's not for any points, but did anyone come up with the theme, reason why I chose those four songs? No. They all repeat their first line twice, of course. Duh, they all, yeah. My life is brilliant, yeah. Ben, what did you have for this next one?
Heard Dave Navarro.
Dave Navarro's correct.
But he's not on tour with the Jane's Addiction at the moment. But anyway, yeah.
Yeah. You toured with the Red Hot Chili Peppers while he was in the band.
Yes, I did. He was really lovely. He's a nice fella.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
How was the rest of the tour?
The tour was really exciting because we, it was the first time we kind of played stadiums and stuff. So, yeah, it was great.
And is it true that you went to Flea's house? I remember you kind of told us that last time.
Yeah, I was kind of dating Flea's nanny at the time. So
nasty.
I got to hang out in Flea's house when he was in New York doing a session with Jewel. Like, how cool
is that? That's probably you ought to know. No, wait, no, that's a different song. That's Alanis Morissette and Jewel are completely different people.
That's right, they are. yes.
What was his house like?
Oh, man, it was really cool. He had this room that was just filled with masks. And then his nanny said, "Oh, do you want to see something really cool?" And there was a bookcase, and the bookcase slid aside, and there was a tunnel, and you got on your hands and knees, crawl through the tunnel, and it came up to this little staircase with an upright bass and a trumpet. And then it was this tiny little room where you'd go and play jazz. And then there was a trap door in the floor that went down into a dungeon. And it was the sex dungeon. No, it was a recording studio.
There was a protein bar in there. And then,
it was a... I wish it was a sex dungeon. No, did I just say that? No.
Question 16. It was Use Your Illusion. Use Your Illusion. And this is going to be my last bit of silly buggers for the night. I'll get it out of the way. Chris, you might have been able to sense in it, but I actually have the power of magic within me as well too. The curse of magic, some might say. A couple of months ago, I did a trick here, and sorry, illusion here, and people loved it. People went freaking crazy for it. They were saying that I'm the new mind freak. Did you hear about that?
I heard that you're ready to be the next naked magician.
So I want it.
Mum, stop!
I would be such a bad naked magician. I'm so like just pale and hairy. I'd be like, "Oh, pick a card. Don't look at my little dick." Anyway,
literally all I've said for the last 9 years, man.
I was gonna try some more magic for you and for you people if you'll have me. Do you wanna? Okay. Here it comes. I got my magic blanket. Now, last time. A couple months ago, I transported myself from the back of the room to the back of that room, and it blew everyone's mind. But now I'm going to do it from the front of the stage, which is even harder, I think. Okay, are you guys ready?
Yes.
Okay, here we go. Simi, can you play some magic music for me, please?
Got this. No, no, why you gotta
be so rude? What the fuck is this? You know
humans do. What? It's magic.
Oh, yeah, okay. Well, the band is magic. That's actually quite clever. I'll
give
you that.
Yeah, you like that sort of thing.
Oh, fuck, I hate this song so much. This is music for dorks. Does anyone... Sorry, does it make some noise if you like that song? Yeah, see what I mean? Look at
them. But not now that you've called us dorks.
sorry, Roxy. Can I get some, like, pump-up music, please?
Yeah. All right.
Okay, can you count me down, Simi? Here we go.
All right. 3, 2, 1, drop up!
All right, it didn't actually work. Never mind. Oh my god, I mind freaked patients to the back of the stage instead.
What? What?
Sorry about that. That might have felt a bit strange.
I gotta tell you, I had a little bit of... I didn't have any weed during the first break. But if I did... Look, I did. And I'm pissed off because I was looking at him going, what songs does he have on his computer? And I had no fucking idea that she was gone. And then when you put the sheet down, I'm like, oh, you've just been making a joke about my industry. Holy shit, patience is at the back! And I'm annoyed that I'm the only magician possibly in the room. And probably the only fuckhead that
me,
fell
obviously.
For that. That was... I'm annoyed and embarrassed and amazed. That was... We should have gone on that fucking date. I knew it. Damn it.
Sorry. On your rider. Sorry if my mind freakery is too much for some. Question 17. Roxette and Madness. They had songs where it must have been love, of course. Love is what we're looking for. The two songs from 1990. Goxie, what did you have?
You Can't Touch This.
You Can't Touch This is correct.
By MC Hammer. And I Touch Myself.
I Touch Myself is correct. Well done.
By the Vinyls.
By the Vinyls, yeah. Correct. Yeah. The Tchaikovsky's three ballets. Swan Lake is one of them. And the Nutcracker is another famous one. This is a harder one. Sleeping Beauty. Well done if you got that.
She's great at soccer and she knows her Tchaikovsky.
You got it. Well done. Well, Emma, what did you have for the Sesame Street character?
We are at Cookie Monster.
That's correct.
I have come for this cookie.
Cookie Monster is correct. Well done. All right, we're going to have a break. Patience and Jeremy are going to choose the champions for the death metal contest, so make yourself known if you'd like to participate in that. And Simi's going to play us a song. Get back into it in 5 minutes.
All right, you can be my Cookie Monster, you can be my Elmo. I don't care, I'm coming around, I'm going to get you, and we're going to do good, we're going to win this thing.
All right, death metal contest contestants, head up now. Come on up. Give them a clap.
You!
So, I will let you know. You, two people, yeah, that's correct. So, Team Jeremy is on 47 points at the moment. Team Patience is on 49 points. So, it's very close. The winner of this will earn 2 points for their side, as well as a little prize. So, this could be a chance to even it up. So, the way we're going to do it, so we're going to play a bit of a background song. You guys listening? Oh my God, you're screaming already. We're going to play a bit of a background song. We'll count you in and then you just give your best. So here's the song. See me? Yeah, this one. So let's do it all together, okay? Everyone, okay? We'll do a warm up. We'll all do a scream, yeah? Okay, here we go.
1, 2, 3.
good. Okay. Let's start maybe with you. We'll start with you. Okay. Okay. I'll count you in. What was your name?
Lewis.
Lewis. Give it up for Lewis, everyone, on Team Patience. Okay. Here's your microphone. Okay. You're doing your warm-ups?
Yeah.
Okay. Simi, play us. That was pretty good. That was pretty good. Okay. We'll go over to this side here. So what was your name?
Jake.
Jake from Team Jeremy. Okay.
Here we go.
1, 2, 3.
But, sorry, I think you muted the mic just as you said it.
Testing.
Sabotage.
Are you up for doing it again?
Thank you.
Are you up for doing it again?
Yes, do it again.
Okay, here we go. Oh, just be careful.
I could hear it from there. Here, though. That was really good.
Okay, all here right. we go. All right.
1, 2.
Do you want to have a go? Here we go. You got this. Thank you. Thank you. And what's your name?
Louise.
Louise, okay. What's your team name, Louise?
Sex and Drugs and Sausage Rolls.
Sex and Drugs and Sausage Rolls. Perfect. Okay, I'll count you in for it too, Louise. Okay, here we go.
1, 2.
Pretty good. And our last contestant, what was your name?
Kieran.
Kieran, and what's your team name tonight?
Oh, no straight answers. Oh,
no straight answers, okay. All right, are you ready to go?
Yeah.
You feeling good? They're pretty good. Take off the chicken.
I have this chicken to sacrifice, though.
Okay, I'll count you in for it, okay.
Yeah.
It was a good start.
Yeah, I think I'm going to build into it. All right. I'm ready.
1, 2.
Thank you.
A bit of a hair metal scream. Well, I forgot to say the prize is a Jameson Black Barrel and the Chris Angel Mind Freak soundtrack. On CD, unopened.
Wow.
I think, yeah, it's unopened. Everyone did fantastic, but I think our winner has to be Jake tonight. What do you guys think? Well done, Jake. This is for you. And this, oh, wait, come get that later. Like I said, please give it up for all our contestants. You did so well. Give them a clap. Oh, God. That was better than I thought it would be. Question 21. How long did the members of Split End spend in a leaky boat? How long did they spend in a leaky boat, allegedly? Everyone's on top of that. Continuing the NZ theme. According to Scribe, how many dudes do you know who can flow like this? According to Scribe, how many dudes do you know who can flow like this? All right, everybody got that. Question 23. We've already heard one tonight, but for 3 points, what were Pat Benatar's 3 top 10 hits in Australia? For 3 points. Also, thanks to Jake's valiant effort in the death metal contest, Team Jeremy's on 49 points. Team Patience is on 49 points. It's scored! Well done, Jake. Next up is an audio question. You might have noticed this over the years. So songs that are produced by Pharrell often have this signature 4-count start. So they repeat the first beat 4 times. You'll start noticing it now. A lot of songs that Pharrell produces. I need you to identify them from that four count start. So it's not too hard, you'll see. It's four of them for 4 points. I'll play them twice. Here we go. Here we go. All right, we're powering through. Question 25 is going to be four answers for 4 points. If you can do it, I reckon you can. I need you to identify the songs from the Weird Al parodies. I'm going to give you the name of the parody song. I need you to tell me the original. So A is I Love Rocky Road. That's quite hard. B is a song just called Jurassic Park. What do you think that might be a parody of? C is Really Inactive. And D was a song called Word Crimes. So give me the songs from the Weird Al parodies. Question 26. This is a bit tricky. You should get one of them. Which two hits by Khalees mentioned bringing boys to the yard? Next up, this question is about a very famous sample. So there's this James Brown sample called the Funky Drama sample. There's kind of been at the birth of hip hop. It gets slowed down and sped up all the time and appears in a bunch of hit songs. This is the original. Three, four, get it. So for this question, I need you to tell me the songs that used the Funky Drama sample. So it's just four songs for 4 points. Oh, it's easy. Come on. You haven't even had the volume question yet. All right, here it is. Got it bad because I'm brown and not the other color, so police think they have the authority to kill a minority. Fuck that shit because I ain't the one for a punk motherfucker with a badge and a gun to be beaten on and thrown in jail. We can go toe-to-toe in the middle of... Again. Question 28. This is going to be two answers for 2 points. Which two Bruce Springsteen albums begin with the word born? They've got album titles that begin with born. Okay, question 29. You might know this. What do these songs have in common? Wagon Wheel, All Along the Watchtower, and Knocking on Heaven's Door. What do they all have in common? Wagon Wheel, they're all hit songs, All Along the Watchtower, and Knocking on Heaven's Door. Goxie said they're all sick. Yeah? Well, I guess I'll accept that. And question 30. If you know it, you know it. If you don't, you don't. Which band did the members of Joy Division form in 1980? Which very successful band did the members of Joy Division form in 1980? I've got a tiebreaker question for you too. Just in case there's a tie, please write in the tiebreaker box down the bottom, of course. You'll never be able to guess this, but have a guess. You won't know it. How many la's are there in Kylie's Can't Get You Out of My Head? How many singular la's? La, 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 la. That's the end of that round. Please swap your answer sheets over.
Yeah.
Question 21. How long did the members of Split Ends spend in a leaky boat? Jeremy.
6 months.
Six
to the
months.
Day.
Lucky just to keep afloat. According to Scribe, Goxie, you're all over this. How many dudes do you know who can flow like that?
Not many, if any.
Correct. Not many, if any.
It's an important song.
The three top hits from Pat Benatar. Ben, what did you guys have for that one?
We Belong, Love is the Battlefield, and Hit Me with Your Best Shot. Is that right? Is that not right?
Look, I think I might have missed one of them. Love is a Battlefield.
Yes.
Wait, is that... Hit me...
Love is a Battlefield.
Fuck, I think I might have fucked this up.
Hit Me with Your Best Shot.
No, I didn't.
And We Belong.
We Belong.
We
and All Fired Up was the other one. But there's a chance that I hit me with your best shot and I just missed it. Let me see. Just talk about yourself. Did you know that All Fired Up was a cover of an Australian band? Here it is. Watch it. Hit Me With Your Best Shot came... No, it didn't. It was number 30. I'm sorry. So it wasn't Hit Me With Your Best Shot. There you go. But it was a great answer. Who wrote Hit Me With Your Best Shot? Oh, you blew it. Sorry, guys. The songs with the four count are Drop It Like It's Hot, Happy, All Right by Kendrick Lamar, and what was the last one, Emma? Did you know that one?
Is it Tokyo Drift?
It was Tokyo Drift, yeah. Well done. Well done. Chris, the Weird Al parodies, I Love Rocky Road.
I Love Rock and Roll.
Correct. Jurassic Park.
So this is the only one we weren't pretty sure on. Ichiku Park.
Oh, okay. Did you just make that up?
Literally, yes. Oh, no, okay. That's a real song.
Oh, okay.
It's all too beautiful.
Oh,
it's
all that song.
Yeah.
Okay.
Christopher Walken sings it.
Oh. Yeah. I only listen to songs by magicians. What about you?
We don't know what we're doing, but we said Total Eclipse of the Heart.
It's MacArthur Park. Well done.
Which one's MacArthur?
MacArthur Park is melting in the dark.
Oh, you should have written it after ours.
Never see that dinosaur again.
Really inactive. What did you have for that?
Radioactive.
Radioactive.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Correct. Yeah.
Banger of a song, too.
And Word Crimes.
Blurred Lines.
Blurred Lines is correct. And also, Blurred Lines has the signature four count start.
Everybody get up.
It's by Pharrell. There you go.
Do you know the trivia that that song ended his marriage? Robin Thicke?
No.
Yeah. That song ended Robin Thicke's marriage.
It's because he was seeing a girl as a couple and then he started seeing...
No, it wasn't that. It wasn't like, we're in... I should have made that joke. He was doing a fan appearance and he grabbed a woman on the bum and she was up for it, but he didn't know when they were taking the photo that there was a mirror behind them.
Oh.
And then he'd lifted up her skirt and grabbed her ass and she was there for it. But then she posted it and then Robin Thicke's wife saw it. And Google it when you get home. It's called You're Gonna Be Alone for a Long Time with That Attitude.
Did you also know his follow-up album, he wrote like an apology album and it was called, I think, For Paula, and it sold maybe 700 copies worldwide?
Kelis mentioned Boys to the Yard in Milkshake. And Bossy. And of course, Milkshake has that four counting show too. Hey, buddy, go. The songs that used the funky drummer sample, Gocs, what did you have?
We had F the Police.
Thank you. F the Police is correct.
Freedom.
Freedom 90, yeah.
It's a Madonna song, right? Vogue, is it?
No, did you guys know it?
We put Erotic down.
Oh, it's Justify My Love.
Oh. Did we get half as... Vote, not vote.
You guys struggled with that last one I saw.
We didn't.
You seemed pretty confident. What
it's
was
the Powerpuff
it?
Girls theme song. It's yes. The Powerpuff Girls theme song.
Powerpuff Girls theme song. Well done.
How did you even know that?
Well done. The Bruce Springsteen albums beginning with Born. Ben, what did you have?
Born in the USA and Born to Run.
Correct. Born in the USA and Born to Run. What did those songs have in common, Emma? Did you know?
We just wrote Bob Dylan.
Yeah, they're all written by Bob Dylan. Oh, yeah. There you go. Bob Dylan song. Do you guys all know that? Oh, you're so clever. Good on you. And Joy Division, Jeremy, you always give us the last answer. What is it?
New Order.
New Order is correct. Well done, Timmy. All right, mark that answer sheet. Total at the top. Back to Team Bong Suit. Just quickly, we're going to go around and collect your answer sheets. But, of course, it's Patience's birthday in 1 week. She means a lot to us, a lot to the show. She means a lot to me personally and everyone on stage. So we got her a nice big cake. We're going to share it with everyone here. So please, let's all sing her happy birthday, please. Happy birthday to you. Oh, look at it. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear patience. Happy birthday to you. Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
And it's specifically decorated like patience you might see on the front. It says there's only one patience. This is some of your artwork and yeah, your outfits and roses at the top. So we're gonna cut it up. Everyone can have some. The top layer is vegan. If you're like me, you can't eat dairy. All right. We're going to come around and collect these answer sheets and enjoy some cake. The results are in. We do have some winners too, which is exciting. Oh my gosh, how fun. Oh, good stuff. Okay. Thanks for coming to Bloody Not On Your Rider. We're doing it every month this year here, and we're taking it on tour to Sydney. If you know anyone in Sydney, please tell them to come along. We need to sell some tickets. We've got Murray from the Wiggles on it. That'll be a lot of fun. But yeah, we'll be here every month. All the tickets are on sale now. Yeah, thanks for coming along. I really appreciate it. Firstly, can you give it up for our panel? Emma Holland, Gocs, Chris, and Ben. And please give it up for the people at the Triffid, Rio and Steve on the sounds. We've got Karen helping us out too, and Simi. Okay, the onstage scores. Team Jeremy is on 63 points.
Respectable.
Team Jeremy's on 63 points. Team Patience is on 67 points. They win. Well done. So thank you, everyone. Thanks so much for coming out. We're going to cheer for every team that's read out. It's the most wholesome way to do it, but we've been mixing it up a bit lately. We did this last time, but we're going to do it again. In last place, we're going to do this sad trombone. All together, okay. In last place, it's Jen Cloacca. That was actually quite cruel. I feel like we just bullied that team. I'm sorry. I regret that. Oh, beautiful. Give it up for Team Impala again for winning 2 points. Now, we always finish these nights with a real singer, Patience, singing us a song. Are you feeling up to sing us a song?
So I'm jazzed up, full of adrenaline. Feel like I've kicked 10 soccer balls. I already had magic happen to me. I zipped to the back of the room, got a cake. It's the best day of my
life.
It's
a big night. All right. Please sing us a song. Here we go.
What Chris and I had. Supposed to mean it.
It must have been love, but it's over now. Lay and whisper on my pillow. Leave the winter on the ground. I wake up lonely, air of silence in the bedroom and on the ground. Touch me now. I close my eyes and drift away. It must have been love, but it's over now. It must have been. We're together, clouds of shelter by your heart. But in and outside, I am water like a teardrop in your palm. But it's a hard winter's day. Thank you.
must have been love, but it's over now. It was all that I wanted, now I'm living without. It must have been love, but it's over now. It's where the water flows, it's where the wind. I came into this world of some reject. Look into these eyes and you'll see the size of the flame.
It must have been love, but it's over now. It must have been good, but I lost it somehow. It must have been love, but it's over now. From the moment time had run out. It must have been love, but it's over now. It was all that I wanted, now I'm living without. It must have been love, but it's over now. It's where the wind blows, it's where the wind.
Thank you, Patience. Thank you, everyone, for coming along. I'll see you next month. Have a fantastic month. Thanks so much for coming.